Are you always a victim of constipation? This is why. Hello everybody, welcome to my YouTube channel. Welcome to Healthy Lifestyle Does Matters. Of course, Healthy Lifestyle Does Matters. Are you always a victim of constipation? This is why. Welcome to another episode of Health Talk. So today we're gonna be talking about constipation, but before I go into that, please, if this is your first time to stumble in my YouTube channel, please subscribe to my YouTube channel, turn on your notification bell, like the video, share the video to friends and families, and please make good use of the comment section by leaving in the comment section what you think about the video, how you handle constipation and stuff like that. Okay guys, without wasting of much time, let's dive into the definition of what constipation, aka hot bowel movement, is. Okay guys, so today we're gonna be talking about constipation. You know, a lot of people, be it kids, adults, age people, I mean 9 out of 10 most people have constipation all the time. Like, legally, constipation is at the rise. Like, I have difficulties using the bathroom, or whatever be the case, So guys, watch this video till the end. This video is gonna tell you why we are always constipated and how to overcome constipation, guys. Hello everybody, now let's go to the constipation itself, all right? So constipation is difficult. It's a difficult moment where to pass out stool, you face it difficult, okay? Difficult bowel movement, or another definition of constipation is when a person passes less than 3 bowel movements a week. Normally, you should pass on a regular basis, everything being okay, ceteris paribus. Everything being okay, you are supposed to pass at least 3 to 4 stools a week. But there are people, get a lot of patients who are experiencing this problem. There are people who pass a week, 2, before they even feel like to use the bathroom. That is constipation in the first order, okay, guys? So, like I said, on a normal basis, you normally, everything being equal, you normally have to pass to at least 3 to 4 times in a week. But like I said, there are people who are tangam, they don't go to the bathroom, or they don't feel like using the bathroom to pass a bowel movement. They stay for like 2 weeks, going to 3 weeks. So that is what we call constipation. It's either where you have difficulties passing out bowel movement, or you stay for more than a week without passing a bowel movement. That is what we call constipation. Okay, guys, without definition of constipation, can we now move to the causes of constipation? Can we now move? Okay, we're gonna move. Okay, guys, so some of the causes of constipation. I know this is a little bit like, how do I put it? This is a little bit strange, but trust me, I've done a lot of research on this and I come to realize that this point, the first points or the first few points I'm going to list to you is something that you never even thought about, or maybe you know the thing, but you didn't know that it can cause you to have constipation, okay? So, causes of constipation, so, or something that can trigger you to be constipated most of times, it's when you travel to a new area, you went on vacation, changes of routine. If your routine was that you get up in the morning, you drink a glass of water before you start your daily activities, changes of routine. If your routine was that you get up in the morning, you do exercise. I mean, changes of routine, traveling or going on vacation, or visiting the different environment, your lifestyle changes, or changes pattern in your lifestyle, medical condition can cause you to have constipation. I know this is a little bit strange because, I mean, we couldn't thought of this could be a cause of constipation, but trust me, it is. I have a lot of patients who are in Texas, and then for some reasons they move out of Texas to Atlanta, to California, to Arkansas, to New North Dakota and stuff like that. They move out to different states, and when they come back, they tell me that, oh, while I was gone, I had this number of constipation, I had these days without going to the bathroom, I didn't feel like to do that. And then I come to realize that environment, changes of lifestyle, routine, the environment where you live, you know, has a role to play when it comes to constipation. Believe it or not, it does. Take it from me. It does, okay? The number two point of causes of constipation is eating less amount of, let me put it this way. This can, I mean, some people can testify, but if you haven't, if it has not happened to you, does not mean it doesn't happen to others, okay? Eating a large amount of milk will get you constipated, okay? Especially our needle milk, you know, the needle milk that it is common in Walmart and in most of our African countries, we do have it. Needle milk or any other milk, but if you're eating milk in large quantities, you are bound to have constipation. I mean, this is not practical to everybody, but 8 out of 10 after eating more than a reasonable amount of milk get to be constipated, just so you know, okay? So you want to limit and take that in minimal in order for you to get rid of constipation, okay? So we are still on the causes of constipation. The second point that I did mention was eating large amount of meat or consuming a more than reasonable amount of milk can cause you to be constipated, okay? The third point that I have for constipation is some medication, e.g. pain pill, blood pressure, all right, can cause you to have constipation. Medical conditions like blood pressure can cause you to have constipation. And also some medication like pain pill, to some people, it causes them to have constipation when they consume it. More than often, it causes them to have constipation, okay? The fourth point that I have as causes of constipation is stress. You know, stress is really not good for our bowels, okay? Stress is really not good for our bowels, because at the end of the day, when we get stressed up, it doesn't really, I mean, you might see it to be something normal to you, but it has something like side effects when it comes to bowel movement, okay? So stress will do you more harm than good. Stay away from stress. Avoid anything that is going to cause you to live a stressful life. Life is too short. You don't want to be living your life as what it is. So the fifth point that I have for you as causes of constipation is that a diet that's low in fiber. A diet that is low in fiber will contribute to constipation. Okay, so you want to make sure you consume diet that is high in fiber. Okay. And then the sixth point as a cause of constipation is that certain medical conditions such as diabetes, lupus, can cause you to have constipation, okay? So, just so you know, and then the seventh point is that when you have bowel surgery in your stomach area like that, you know, in the abdomen, you are bound to experience constipation, okay? So if you know you've had surgery in the past, present or past be the case, and you know, is you're likely gonna have constipation. So just so you know, okay? So the eighth point as a cause of constipation is a little or no physical activities. Guys, you realize that one thing has a role to play with another thing and has a role to play with another thing. Like this causes that, you know, stuff like that. So when I tell people to exercise, it is for your freaking good. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, it is for your good. So please exercise. Like I said, I understand we are too busy. I'm emphasizing on exercise because you see, lack of exercise will cause you to have high blood pressure. And now we're talking about constipation. It will still cause you to have constipation. So guys, think about it. One thing leads to another, from one thing to another. You don't want to be doing all these, guys. Just get this thing out of the way and practice healthy lifestyle. Does matter. Of course it does matter. Okay guys, so like I was saying, when it comes to exercise, I understand we are having a very busy schedule. You gotta go to work, you gotta go to school, you got family to take care of, you are a married person or married woman or stuff like that, you got family to take care of, you got the whole house and stuff like that to take care of. But in between that, please create time to do exercise. I would say exercise does not only mean you have to go to the gym and run or whatever be the case. You can still do exercise by walking, you know, from one place to another. Just make sure you're doing exercise to keep your bones, you know, to keep them flexible, keep your nerves. Everything should be intact, okay? So, all right. So the ninth point as a cause of constipation is not drinking enough water or dehydration. Dehydration is gonna is one of the primarily cause of constipation. Dehydration, not drinking enough water. And these attacks mostly happen during winter. Winter people don't tend to drink a lot of water, and that is why during the winter, a lot of my patients are so constipated. Before, you know, oh, can I have a stool softener? Can I have a laxative? Can I have this? This is because, I mean, winter tends to be cold, but that doesn't mean you shouldn't drink water. Because, I mean, it's less during summer that there is sun. Of course, people get to be thirsty. At the end of the day, they get to drink water or liquid or whatever be the case. But during winter, guys, that's worse because, I mean, it's getting cold. People drink little or no water for couple of days before even so please guys, we need to drink water. All right, so the 10th point that I have for you as a cause of constipation is ignoring the urge to have a bowel movement can lead to constipation for example kids. Okay, so children, because they love playing and engaging in activities that, you know, that suits them, they want to use the restroom, they want to pee, they want to poo, but they're gonna like stick it onto themselves until they finish what they are doing. I mean, piling or feeling the urge to use the bathroom for bowel movement, and you vehemently refuse not to use the bathroom at that moment can cause you to have constipation. Because you want to feel, and this is what happened, I'm saying it out of experience because I also get constipated too. So, like I said, we all are learning, okay, guys? So, sometimes when I'm in class, for example, when I'm in class and I really want to use the bathroom, like, to have a bowel movement, but the topic is really, especially in lab, but the topic is really, really interesting, and I feel like if I leave, I'm going to miss a point. I'm gonna miss a point, and then for me to come back, we might be engaging in carrying out the lab activities for that day, and you know, I will be able to go back to where I left before I went to the bathroom. So this is what I do. 9 out of 10, I hold it on to myself, and I wait till that section is finished, then I'll go. And before you know, guys, I'm just saying it out of my own experience. Leave it in the comment section. What's your experience, sir? When I leave, let's say I wait till the end of the class to go to the bathroom, guess what? When the class is over, I no longer fear to use the bathroom. That has happened to me once, twice, thrice. I mean, when I want to use the bathroom and I don't use it, and you know, I, you know, try to put it to myself or let it be within me, and when the class is finished or whatever activities I was focusing on is finished, I don't even feel the urge again to go to the bathroom. Okay, when you don't feel the urge again to go to the bathroom, that is when the poo start getting harder, because I mean, they really want to come out, but you held them, and then now they are, you know, stiff, and you know, they've gone back, and you don't feel to as you use the bathroom, and before you know, another one is coming. The two of them now merge, and just imagine, that is why you constantly have constipation. So guys, if you feel, I've stopped it because I cannot be saying what I don't practice, I have stopped it, but if you feel the urge to use the bathroom, please use the bathroom at that moment. There's a reason why you feel urge to use the bathroom at that time, so please don't take it for granted or else you'll be constipated. Okay, so the 11th point is the abuse of laxative, overuse of laxative. Okay, just like I said in the video that I posted on how to properly swallow pills. No, was that a video? I think something like that. So when we abuse medication, the usage of medication or the consumption of medication, it has an effect. Like I will always say, if it was okay, just like you feel like it's okay for you to do things at your will, then there will be legally no reason why there is prescription or directions on medication. Okay, guys? So we have to learn to take or consume medication per our doctor's directions. Okay, when you abuse, just because, let me use this because this is what happens to a lot of my patients at work, and then when I talk to them, I mean, they see reasons with me, so let me bring it here. Okay, so when you are constipated for the first start, and you came and tell the nurse or whoever be the person in charge, the nurse, the doctor, the medic, or whatever be the setting of where you're working at. When you are constipated and you tell your doctor, that, hey, I'm constipated, can I have something for constipation? It's fine. The doctor can either give you stool softener, Decocet, or any other laxative, prune juice. It can be prune, yeah, people use prune juice too. They use it. So let's say you're constipated and then you talk to your doctor and your doctor give you laxative. Let's say the doctor give you Decocet for you to use for pain, it's too softener, okay? And the doctor says, take two tablet or take one tablet. Okay, take one tablet every, take one tablet and take two tablet after 5 days if you haven't passed, it's two, okay? So the instruction is clear that take it after 5 days or 2 days if you haven't passed any two or stuff like that. And because you waited for 1 day and you haven't passed its two, doesn't mean that medication is not working. I would advise you to wait for the 2 days or whatever duration the doctor gave you. And if you don't have bowel movement, you are not authorized to take another pill without the doctor's consent. Call the doctor. I mean, the world is now computerized and modern. We have our doctor's number on the phone where we do online consultation and stuff like that. So you can legally call your doctor or call your doctor's office and say, hey, I took this pill. It's been 3 days, 2 days as per your direction, and I haven't had a bowel movement. Is it okay if I can take another one? And the doctor will tell you if it is okay for you to take another stool softener or laxative. Then on your own, you cannot just take them just because you didn't have a bowel movement for the 2 days that the doctor instructed does not give you the go ahead to take another pill without his consent. Okay? So please, let us not abuse the use of laxative, because at the end of the day, when we abuse the use of laxative, we start passing out bowel movement like nonstop. We start having diarrhea, dysentery and stuff like that. We don't want to get to that point, because I've seen somebody who overtook laxative. I'm telling you this because I work in the hospital setting and I've seen things. I've seen people who over exaggerate the consumption of laxative. They would take a stool softener and then in between that they are drinking prune juice like crazy, taking Merrylax and stuff like that. That is three whole medication. I mean, and you didn't even ask your doctor if it was okay. And before you know, you start passing through non-stop. You start having that weird dysentery and stuff like that. That is not cool. Because at the end of the day, when you have diarrhea, oh, I don't want to talk about that, because it first of all makes you very, very uncomfortable, okay? It makes you very, very uncomfortable, okay? So when you are taking pills, your doctor knows the pills that you are already taking before giving you a laxative. That is why you should talk to your doctor before you consume, if you feel like you want to consume another laxative other than the one that he prescribed and asked you to take at a given moment. You have to consult with your doctor, because you might be taking other medications and which has a side effect, and you consume now a laxative in an exaggerated amount and it becomes worsened. You know, you start passing out bowel movement until you start passing out blood. This is so crazy, y'all. Let's practice to do things the right way and follow instructions, okay? So, let's talk about the remedies. We talk about the causes. Now, let's talk about the remedies of constipation. Let's give the solution of constipation. Okay, guys. So, the first solution when you are having constipation is to talk to your doctor, because your doctor we check the medication you are taking, because some medication can cause you to have constipation. So the first one is to talk to your doctor that, hey, doctor, hey, ma'am, hey, sir, I am constipated, and the doctor will first of all run through the list of medications you are taking and find out if some if you have one or two medication among your medications that is causing you to have constipation. And if your doctor does not find one, then your doctor will prescribe you a laxative that you can take to help you have bowel movement. Okay, laxative, like I didn't mention of Merrylax, I didn't mention of stool softener Decosate, I didn't mention of prune juice. This one you can legally buy it in Walmart, but before you consume, like I said, talk to your doctor. Is it okay if I go to Walmart and get prune juice to help me if it's okay and stuff like that? Okay, so the number one solution is to talk to your doctor, and your doctor will do a rundown check of your medication. Okay, we did mention that travel, vacation are some of the causes of constipation, believe it or not. So on this one, as a remedy, what I want you to do is that, I mean, I cannot stop people from traveling because I travel a lot. I travel a lot, so I can't stop people from traveling, because traveling to me is just my hobby and I like it. I feel so good when I travel, like it makes me feel like, oh, I am okay. I get to get off work and school in my brain. I just have to, you know, go to the park or, you know, and stuff like that, to the water parks and stuff like that, and then just see nature. I feel so good when doing that. So I love traveling, so I won't tell you to stop traveling because it will cause you constipation. Just make sure that even though you are on a vacation, you are still maintaining your regular routine. Okay, that is a remedy. Okay, and then another solution to constipation, we didn't mention that some medication, I already talked about that when I asked you to consult your doctor. And then the third point, as a cause that we want to use it as remedy, is stress. It's not good for bowel movement, so you want to manage stress amicably. And then the next point of remedies of constipation is that you know, make sure that you are drinking enough water, guys. Water is so good. It is so good for your health, okay? This is something that I really want you to know, okay? Somebody brought this to my attention, and I really want to address it now. So, let me tell you something. Let me give you a tips. When you are, when you see somebody's skin tone, like when you see somebody's skin tone and you admire it, trust me, it's not all about lotion. It's all about what the person consumes. Let me give you a heads up. If you want a healthy body, a healthy skin tone, I'm not saying it means bleaching. I'm just saying that if you want a healthy skin tone or whatever, if you want to look healthy, you eat healthy, but you want to look healthy, guys, it's what you eat. Okay, what you eat is gonna reveal. What you eat is gonna reveal outside, and that's how we get to see it. Sometimes when you go to the hospital, you don't need to tell your doctor you are sick. Just physically, your doctor know you are sick, either from malnutrition or stuff like that, or environment deficiency and stuff like that. They could tell even from your eyes, okay? So, guys, if you, like I was saying, if you see somebody and you admire their skin tone or whatever be the case, it's because it's not all about lotion. Lotion too is good. You want to make sure you're using the best lotion that suits your skin color, not bleaching, okay, y'all? So if you see somebody blotching, looking the way you want to be looked, then you have to realize that it starts from eating, exercising, and stuff like that. I mean, lotion is good, but it's not all about lotion. I'm not going to emphasize on that because I'm not talking about skin care routine today, okay? So another thing is that, remedy is that, do physical exercise, like I always said. And another thing is that, when you feel the urge to use the bathroom, please use the bathroom at that moment, because there is a reason why you feel as you use the bathroom at that moment. So please use the bathroom at that moment, okay? Because one of the harmful causes of you being constipated is that it can lead to infection. Let me tell you how constipation can lead to infection. When you are constipated and you really need to use the bathroom, but you are afraid to use the bathroom because the stool is too hard. When your stool is too hard, you pass out blood. And when you are forcing the stool out, it can tear you from the anus. It can give you a tear from the anus. And when it gives you a tear in the anus, your body is now open for bacteria. Your body is now open for infection. Okay, guys? So please, let's do things the right way. If you feel as you use the bathroom, please use the bathroom. Okay, drink enough water so that you will not be constipated. Because if you are constipated, when you try to... Because constipation is like... Bowel movement is like pregnancy. When you are pregnant, I mean, irrespective of the pain you're feeling, you need to push the baby out. That is a fact. You cannot hold it onto yourself, because at that point, the baby does not want to stay in you, but the baby wants to get out. I don't know how you're going to do it, but the baby has to come out. So that is the same like bowel movement. You want to go, but it's really hard. You feel like it's painful, but you have to go because, of course, you have to go. So when you push it too hard, it will tear you in your anus, and it will give you a wound in your anus, and that wound is not open. Your skin is not open for bacteria, infection, and stuff like that. So please, let's do this the right way, okay? And then also, as a solution, eat dietary or look of dietary fiber, like eat food good in dietary fiber, okay? So guys, that is all what I have for you today. I know we've talked a couple of things. So please, like I said, make use of the comment section below how you get rid of constipation and stuff like that. If this is your first time, please subscribe to my YouTube channel, like the video, share the video with friends and family. Don't forget, your comment on the comment section below is needed. So please, now you know the reason why you are always a victim of constipation. I know and I trust you are going to take those remedies seriously. You're going to drink water, you're going to go to the bathroom when you feel to go to the bathroom, and then you're still going to eat food rich in fiber. You're going to not abuse the consumption of laxatives. You're going to follow your doctor's instructions, because I know we all are reasonable and we follow instructions. Thank you guys for watching. Stay tuned for the next video. Please, if you haven't subscribed, please, I urge you to do so. I'll see you in the next video. Okay, guys. Bye. Love you.